In the build-up to the race, different athletes will do different things. What worked for me is being totally focused on the race itself and what I'm about to do. I'm about to try to execute this race the exact way I planned and practiced and worked with my coach to execute it.
So, gun goes off, the objective here is to get up to speed as quickly as possible. So, coming out of the curve now, at 100 meters into the race, you want to just relax. I'm pretty relaxed here, and I haven't really made a move on any of the athletes, but at 200, you want to start making a move. This is where now, as I'm going past Roxburgh Martin on the outside, from 200 to 300, where I really make the move and position myself where I want to be. And with 100 meters to go, I've got control of the race. Now, it's really just trying to maintain form, run through the finish line. So this was a much more conservative race than I would normally run because I had the 200 meters coming up later. So ordinarily I would have taken that race out a lot faster, but in order to conserve as much energy, it was a much more conservative and much more safe race. So that's why it was 43:49 instead of a world record. I felt like I was in world record shape for the 400 meters at that particular time, but having to run the 400 and 200, I needed to be more conservative for that race. Okay, so this is the 200 meters a couple of days later. Now, I had just broken the world record a month before at our Olympic trials on that same track, given the shape that Frankie Fredericks was in and Otto Bolden, that it was going to take a world record to win it. Not really feeling fatigued from the 400 because I did conserve as much as possible on that race. I knew this was going to be the most difficult race. This was going to be the harder one, much tougher competition. And 200 meters being a much more technical race, much more likely to make some mistakes, which I did right there. Three steps out of the blocks, I stumbled but kept going. So now I've got a really good turn going. That was always my advantage, running a really good bend. Come off the curve, I'm in control of the race, and just like the 400 now, it's just maintaining form and really, really focused on just clean, clean technique through to the finish line. I knew that I could break a world record. I didn't know by how much, but I knew that I could. I knew that I probably would. And so it was great to break the world record. It was great to break the world record, but also at the same time, you know, to win the 200 meters, which I hadn't won in Barcelona, and also to, most importantly, to be successful at completing the double.